Las Vegas shimmers seductively like a vulgar showgirl on the Mojave horizon.
Ladies and gentlemen, we bring you Ancient Rome.
In the year 3000.
And our special guest.
Recording star.
Jewel.
Skitsplex is ready to hand over the device.
Very good, Lieutenant.
Chuck Woolery, you're alive.
No, Doctor, it's the General.
I'm here, Granddad, for the omnipotential remote.
Ah, yes, my life's work. It's ready. You have exactly 24 hours to get to your...
Yeah, the Arctic testing site. Ow!
Careful, it's hot. Now listen closely. No one else knows what I'm about to tell you. In order to deactivate the device, you must first take off. Goodness.
Go on here.
Gerald? Oh, my God. Where's the doctor?
Who cares? Where's my damn device?
Shall I contact the Pentagon?
No. Those boys will never let us hear the end of it. Get me Helena Troy.
I'm just a spy.
Spy Crew. File number Gamatron 5, Mother Touch Yourself 7. Codename Virtual Vegas. The Maxi Bar. A Stark cocktail palace filled with decadent human decor.
The entrance password has now changed. The new password is Bliss.
Agent number one and agent number two fulfill their obligation as permanent fixtures of the scene.
He is a pest and should be controlled.
No. Humans and buildings are the pests, and he's just accidentally stepping on them.
Hey, boys.
It's Miss Babe Almighty, known to our agents as Mac, their usual cocktail waitress.
Mac, is Godzilla a controllable pest
or an unstoppable force of nature?
Godzilla is a big rubber lizard designed by Japanese movie execs who have an obsession with size.
Do you have an obsession with size?
Obsession? I'd call it a preference. The usual?
Sure. Make mine a double.
Agent number one takes a call on his holographic wrist phone. Swiss quartz movement and water resistant up to 1,000 feet.
It's Helena Troy.
She's a devastating diva who knows just how and when to call the shots.
What's up, boss?
A governmental play toy known as the Omnipotential Remote has been stolen from a top secret military lab.
How top secret?
The only known access is by guest appearance in the Siegfried and Roy show.
That's top secret.
This Omnipotential Remote thingamajig can be programmed to control any machine the user chooses in the wrong hands.
There's no telling what it could be used for.
It could be used to launch a thermonuclear attack on Orlando, Florida.
Yes. Or it could be used for evil.
I need you boys to find that remote thing ASAP. It's set to activate 20 hours from now.
How do we deactivate it?
The only man who can stop it, Dr. Schizoplex, was kidnapped with the remote.
Luckily, his brain is so dangerous, the government requires him to wear a permanent low-jack tracking anklet.
Like Regis Philbin.
Exactly. But for different reasons.
Now, the doctor has been tracked to somewhere within the brand new Vegas Hotel and Casino.
Description.
It's a high-tech gambling palace designed to lure movie stars and millionaire models.
Typical all-your-ego-can-eat buffet.
You got it. The owner is a man named Johnny Nevada.
Profile?
Non-existent. No records whatsoever. On paper, this man is as blank as Jean-Claude Van Damme on Celebrity Jeopardy. I'm sending you the doctor's LoJack locator. Remember, boys, Vegas is like a game of strip poker. You better hide your hand. Or you'll be showing your ass.
In the Vegas tradition of recreating the world's greatest treasures, Johnny Nevada has recreated Las Vegas itself in the heart of Vegas. Contact your local travel agent for details.
Don't scratch it. Okay, we've got a problem. Something's jamming the frequency on the doctor's LoJack anklet.
Slots. Looking to get lucky?
There's no such thing as luck.
Spoken by a true control freak.
Jackpot.
Keep the change.
I'm not a control freak.
Yeah, prove it.
Later. Right now, one of us, you, will penetrate the state-of-the-art security system and find out what's jamming the frequency.
Thank you, Mr. Control Freak.
And I
get to have the fun job of hanging out in the casino with all the beautiful women?
Yes.
Now, prove you're not a control freak.
How?
Stop strategizing. Just trust your hunches and accept the luck of the draw.
There's no such thing as luck.
Yeah? Follow me.
Once inside the gambling Blitz Palace, audio animatronic Vegas legends greet all who enter with a swanky hello.
Those threads are my sugar bag.
Oh, yeah, welcome.
Watch. 10,000 on 12.
You crazy?
Yeah, according to you, yes.
Devil six, and we have ourselves a winner. $300,000 to our new player.
Thank you very much. Just a little luck, you know?
Okay. You want a lot of money, but are we any closer to the bad guy?
Bad guy in 3, 2, 1.
Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Johnny Nevada, the owner and proprietor of this here gambling establishment. I had to mosey on over and see who was taking all my money.
I'm Agent Number 2.
And I'm Agent Number 1.
We're spies.
Well, the only thing you'll find at the Vegas is a hootin' good time.
Daddy, the Wayne Newton animatronic is malfunctioning again. It's slapping male customers' butts and calling them Chicky Baby.
You sure it's not Merv Griffin? Because this morning at breakfast, he was squeezing more than the oranges, if you know what I mean. Where are my manners? Boys, this is my genius daughter.
Sierra Nevada.
I raised the child from birth to be a showgirl, but she up and ran off to MIT.
And now I return, the prodigal daughter.
Prodigal daughter.
Excuse me, gentlemen. I have a sick animatronic to attend to.
You know, she builds all them robot thingies herself.
Impressive.
All right, boy. Now it's time for me to lasso some of my money back.
Well, I'm afraid he has other...
I'm afraid he doesn't have a choice.
Moments later, Agent Number 1 has infiltrated the inner workings of the hotel.
That was easy.
All right, I knocked your block off. Looks like your luck's taking a turn.
You're so hot. You're likely to pull me out of retirement from the world's oldest profession.
If I didn't know any better, I'd call this luck.
There's no such thing as luck.
Spy Groove, file number Gamatron 5, Mother Touch Yourself 7, Part 2. In the evil Johnny Nevada's hotel, Agent Number 1 is caught off guard by the beguiling Sierra Nevada.
How did you get past the infrared motion scanning security system?
Infrared blocking lotion number 15.
There's no such thing.
I invented it myself. Also comes in a spray.
Impressive.
Now I have a question for you. Why are you jamming my frequencies?
Because the animatronics are controlled by frequencies. I have to keep the airwaves clear so they don't freak out.
Okay, one more question.
It's not your turn, but go ahead.
These things operate via pre-recorded voice-activated response impulse modulator, right?
That's right.
If you take the gun off me, I might be able to give you a little tip.
This? It's just a laser-targeting pneumatic staple gun I created for hard-to-reach jobs. Could you pull back Wayne Newton's hairline?
Sure. I believe a ribbed delayed-action coil receptor would simulate a more naturalistic human response time.
Lubricated or unlubricated?
Unlubricated. I happen to have one in my wallet.
Why don't you save that one for later? I have a whole drawer full in the next room.
A whole drawer full?
I'll go get one.
Get two.
Don't move.
Anything?
Nothing. And we've got less than 3 hours.
No problem. I switched the jammer off. The LoJack locator should work now.
Great. I'll locate the missing geek and the thing. We'll get the hell out of here.
Sounds like the fun job sucks.
Oh, what? I can't hear you. You're breaking up.
Are you there? So, how lifelike can you make these things?
Completely. Well, not completely. For example, I can never quite get them to kiss.
Stuck with the crappy job, Agent Number 2 searches for the missing Dr. Schizoplex using the voice-enhanced LoJack locator.
Come on, baby, we're running out of time. Where is he?
Cold. Warm. Warmer. Hot. 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 Oh, baby, I'm on fire. I'm getting a headache.
You're driving me crazy. Oh, don't stop. Don't stop. That's the spot. Oh, Daddy, yes.
Great. The ankle attachment, but no doctor, and no omnipotential remote.
Yes, yes.
Vegas. Weird. The Rat Pack meets Chuck E. Cheese.
Ooh, as that cuckoo song says, the end is near, baby.
Whoa, Rat Pack gone bad.
Major malfunction. Follow me.
Scooby-Doo, Scooby-Doo, Scoop, Scoop. Get him, Scooby-Doo away.
Slap.
Frank 4, Sammy 2, Dean 8, shut down. Something must have interfered with their frequencies. It was you.
Sierra, I...
turned off the frequency jammer.
But...
I thought I could trust you.
You're now entering the Venice floor, where we bring you Venice, Vegas style.
I'm sorry. I'm gonna tell Sierra why we're here.
What?
I'm gonna tell her.
We can't do that.
Why?
We're spies.
But I...
Have a hunch?
No.
Feeling lucky?
No.
So you not believe in luck?
No.
Are you feeling lucky in the spy department or the girl department?
Listen, we have less than 2 hours to find the omnipotential remote, Dr. Schizoplex, and stop Johnny Nevada, or there's no telling what could happen. Sierra knows this hotel, and I have a feeling we can trust her.
Oh, could that feeling be defined as a hunch?
It's not a hunch. It's a calculated risk based on a limited amount of information.
That's a hunch.
You'll call it what you like.
Go.
Thank you.
Talk to her.
Okay, I will. You should go clean yourself up.
You're now entering the Hoboken floor, where we bring you Hoboken, New Jersey. Vegas style.
Oh, wait, what?
Good luck.
Stop it.
Welcome to the solid gold Hoboken Path Train Station men's room. Vegas style. While in Hoboken, take a swim in our spectacular reproduction of the Hudson River.
Cigar, cigarette, prime rib.
No, thank you.
I'm European.
Enjoy the all-you-can-eat floating barge buffet. The toxic waste is not only edible, it's delicious.
Sierra, I have to talk to you.
I'm busy. Half the animatronics went haywire when you turned my jammer off. Look, I can't trust you anymore.
Yes, you can. Please, listen to me.
Why? Give me one good reason.
Because you and all of Las Vegas are in grave danger.
After a spin on a Hoboken toilet, Agent Number 2 finds himself in a mysterious, dark storage area.
Cigar, cigarette, prime rib.
Unbelievable. Is anyone in this hotel real?
Me? I'm real. Oh, thank God you've found me.
Dr. Schizoplex.
If this dangerous thing is in the hotel, then I have to tell my father.
About your father?
Wait, before you speak another word.
I think your father's involved in this.
Our kissing?
No. He may have stolen the omnipotential remote. I'm sorry to involve you, but we're running out of time.
Oh, no. My father? Elvis 4, go. Liberace 7, go.
What are you doing?
I'm sorry, but I just can't play this game anymore. Oh, no. My father. Scary device, stolen remote, blah, blah, blah. Enough. I have way too much to do. And you're right. We are running out of time.
Using his Zippo laser hacksaw, Agent Number 2 frees Dr. Schizoplex.
You must listen to me. Sierra's mad. Mad as that pretty blonde girl and the monsters. Why was she living there? Sure, they claim to be related, but they were monsters. And then there's Maud. Ride on, Maud.
Doc?
We must flee this place at once. The omnipotential remote has never been tested. When it activates, there's no telling what could happen.
So that means that everyone in this town is in danger, and you're the only one who can save them.
Oh, my.
This is what you've been looking for. The omnipotential remote.
It was in your tool belt the entire time.
If it was a snake, it would have bit you.
So, what do you plan to do with it?
I'm about to control every casino in the city, thanks to this. And these!
Okay, 400 robotic grandmothers and...
I call it my blue hair brigade. A marching army of senior citizen robots.
What are you gonna do, bankrupt Medicare?
No, Las Vegas. I've programmed the omnipotential remote to cause slot machines to hit jackpot. Each blue hair is fitted with a receiver for the omnipotential remote. When the remote activates, my blue hair brigade will be able to sit at any slot machine in Vegas and hit nothing but jackpot.
So, you're gonna crash the economy of Vegas.
It's good, isn't it? Here's the best part. I use the winnings to buy up Vegas hotel by hotel. I will control Las Vegas. I will decide who wins and who loses. I will be Lady Luck.
You're a control freak.
Takes one to know one.
Why did you choose to use your magnificent brain for evil?
Oh, I'm just trying to run a business.
You'll never get away with this.
How surprisingly cliché, but more importantly, inaccurate. There are only two things that can stop me. Dr. Schizoplex, and I'm about to kill him.
What's the other?
You, my dear Agent Number One. I'm sorry, but I can leave nothing to chance. Goodbye. Elvis 4, Liberace 7, Crush. I'm sorry we didn't work out.
Or sorry.
Spy Groove, file number Gamatron 5, Mother Touch Yourself 7, Part 3. In the control room of the Vegas Vegas Hotel and Casino, Agent Number 1 is locked in a lethal embrace.
Hang on. Quickly, open their butts.
I'm not entirely comfortable doing this.
This is very, very complex. Look for a button marked off.
We have 10 minutes to find the omnipotential remote, or Sierra could destroy Vegas.
Heaven help us. The remote is in Sierra's tool belt. How do we disable it?
Ah, is your name Elizabeth?
Doc.
I'm sorry. You must cut the red wire.
Cut the red wire.
Not the blue one.
Thank you, Dr.
Blue bad.
Red? Right.
Doc.
Any clue where Sierra is?
She left to kill him.
Oh.
Oh, damn it. People are never where you need them to be when it's time to kill them.
Sierra.
You're still alive? Note to self, find a more efficient way of killing people.
I'm afraid the game is over for you and your father.
Is it? Daddy won. Shut down.
Oh, I should have known. Give us the remote, you power-tripping maniac.
Let's do it Vegas style. You boys up for a little shell game? Daddy one, go. Daddy two, go. Daddy three, go.
Good luck, boys.
Oh, and just to make things interesting, Blue Hair Brigade, go!
Piggyback.
Looking to get lucky.
Come and get it, boys.
Punch a John maneuver?
Chips. No way.
Dueling evil Knievels.
Ah, yes.
Ah, yes.
They're splitting up. Any hunches?
You go after that one, and I'll go after that one. If we're both wrong, we might still have time to catch the third one.
That's not a hunch. That's a plan.
Okay, my hunch is if we keep talking, they'll all get away.
Enough said. Let's go.
Nothing!
Snake eyes.
Empty. It must be that one.
Damn.
That's the way the shell game is played. You have 30 seconds. Catch me if you can.
This is insane. Sierra, what are you doing?
I'm climbing up here to where it's safe.
Safe?
In 20 seconds, this remote is going to activate, and I've reprogrammed it to cause the lasers in this light show to cut everyone to ribbons. Note to self, found a more effective way to kill people.
What'd she say?
She gonna kill everybody.
Safer at the top of this statue than it is down there.
Using his combination beeper slash towing cable, Agent Number One shoots a line to the giant cowboy.
Got it. Okay,
quickly. Remove the back. Cut the red wire.
They're both red. Oh, man.
The wires are both red!
Then go with your hunch!
We did it.
I'm sorry, Sierra.
Someday, maybe we'll meet again. You and the real me.
What's important is that you got the omnipotential remote, defused it, saved the doctor, and everyone loves you.
Yeah, and I had a hunch she was bad.
Well, why don't you tell me?
You said you didn't believe in hunches.
I don't believe in Santa Claus either, but I'll happily take a present from him.
Yeah, and you'll take a kiss from a robot.
Yes, but that was because I didn't know she was a robot.
Whoa. You kissed a robot?
You know that I kissed a robot.
I don't train you to kiss robots.
Well, no, woman replaced herself with the robot.
Yes, exactly. She slipped me a robot, basically.
Yeah, slipped like a robot.
I was slipped a robot.
Like a Mickey?
Basically.
Well, she was real. When we first saw her, and at some point she changed into a robot.
She switched herself for a robot.
Not just a robot.
Yeah, I didn't know, of course, you know.
You let something get past you.
Yeah, exactly.
She was a robot back when she was sending off all her dads, you know.
Yeah,